the age of 85, Glenn Elliott can look back over a long career as a Texas Ranger, a force often called the greatest organization of its kind in the world. On October 13th, the city of Longview will dedicate a baseball field in Elliott's name, one of many honors that he's received over his lifetime. Joan Hallmark fills us in tonight's Proud of East Texas.
Two books have been written about Glenn Elliott's life and adventures as a Texas Ranger. Texas Monthly Magazine has featured him on their cover, and he's even the subject of a museum display. Just one look at the Glenn Elliott display here at the Grant County Historical Museum, and you can tell that Glenn Elliott is a legend. Now come along and meet the man.
I've worked every time of day, Sean, in the book just about it, and I had a good time doing it all.
So how does a self-proclaimed country boy from Windham become a legend in one of the most famous law enforcement agencies in the world? Well, it all begins with hard work, which includes 100 hours a week on the job, driving 1,000 miles a week on the road, and taking few vacations or comp time.
The last 29 years that I worked, I took off one day sick.
Then there's Elliott's dogged determination to sniff out clues and solve crimes in some of the highest profile cases in the country, including the chewing gum air murderer, the hot oil scandals, and the Kilgore, Kentucky fried chicken murders.
People were killed. They carried them down on the oil lease in Rush County and killed them.
Some of Elliott's cases have been every bit as bizarre as anything you'll see on television, CSI, or Criminal Minds.
You remember the guy's head cut off?
An East Texas teenager who slaughtered his mother, father, and grandfather. The mother who left her five-year-old beside the road where he died from exposure. And the serial killer who left a string of bodies across East Texas are only a sampling of Elliott's cases during his 38 years as a highway patrolman and Texas Ranger. These stories and more are detailed in Elliott's books, Glenn Elliott, A Ranger's Ranger, and Glenn Elliott, Still a Ranger's Ranger. You've been shot at a few times?
Yeah, sure, I've been shot at.
While Elliott carried a .45 automatic at all times during his career and was shot at numerous times, he says he only had to actually use his gun twice. But in spite of the danger, Elliott loved his job.
I had several opportunities to promote, but I didn't want to. I like to work out the field. I didn't want to sit behind my desk.
Elliott is the first to admit he didn't get rich as a Texas Ranger, but he did have rich experiences and fascinating friends.
I got to be a good friend of Paul Harvey.
Commentator Paul Harvey was a fishing partner, and in security details, Elliott often rubbed shoulders with presidents and other dignitaries. Elliott's Longview home is filled with mementos of his law enforcement past. Although many of the most prized possessions have been donated to Texas Ranger auctions, which provide college scholarships for Ranger children. Now, at the age of 85, Glenn Elliott looks back over his life with satisfaction. And his newest honor, having a baseball field named after him, is just icing on the cake for this very deserving Texas Ranger.
It's a great honor. It's a great honor. Well, I'm just tickled to death.
Until next time, in Longview, I'm Joan Hallmark.
The Glenn Elliott Baseball Field will be dedicated Thursday morning at 10:30 at Lear Park Baseball Complex.